So let's look at a system that is not even unusual that combines all of these three forms of parallelism. So we can have a dual socket motherboard that has two chips with four cores on each chip, and each core can simultaneously run two threads using simultaneous multithreading. So as far as the programmer is concerned and as far as the operating system is concerned, what we really have is 2 times 4 times 2, which means that 16 threads, or for that matter 16 different single-threaded programs, can run simultaneously, and a relatively simple operating system would just treat these as 16 largely equivalent cores. This can be a big problem, because let's say that we actually have 3 threads and the operating system, not knowing any better, just maps them to the first 3 threads that it has. But it turns out that these two are really threads on the same core that compete with each other for issue slots and other things in an out-of-order processor. And then, really, the first half of these threads, 8 of them, are really on the same chip, so we're using only half of the overall cache capacity that the system has. Pretty much, we have a very large cache in the other chip that we are not using. So a much smarter policy for using 3 threads would be to put them on different chips if we can, and definitely on different cores if we can, so that they don't compete. So the idea would be that you would first run threads such that they're distributed among the chips so that you maximize the cache capacity that you're benefiting from. Then we also want to make sure that we first map a thread to each core, and only then do we want to actually map threads to the second thread in each core, so that if there are fewer threads, they don't need to share the resources of the same core. Each gets its own core. And that requires the operating system to actually know what's going on. So most of the well-known operating systems like Windows and Linux and so on will actually be able to figure this out. But that means that as we have this fancy hardware that has parallelism at different levels of granularity, we also have to make our operating systems aware of that. So it's not just expose more thread contexts that the operating system can use. It actually matters how you use these thread contexts.